What's up, ODS Squad? It's Marcel from One Dapper Street, and today I just kind of want to give you a little bit of an update of what I've been doing during the quarantine, how I've been holding up, how things have changed. I've got a few book recommendations for you and a few other things that I want to point out that I think are going to help you stay safe and sane during all of this. So let's jump right in. I want to actually talk to you about five books that I've read in the past that I think are a great read right now, especially during the quarantine. This is the first one. It's called Making Habits, Breaking Habits by Jeremy Dean. I think so many of our habits are already broken right now because we're so much out of our normal loop, but this book kind of like talks about how you can put off self-control and kind of trigger your unconscious to do a lot of the things for you. So how do you break your bad habits? How do you make good ones? And I think it's honestly an excellent book, and I think right now we have so much time and headspace to create new habits and ways we work, so I think this is a great read right now. Then we've got The Marshmallow Test, which talks about self-control itself. It is written by Walter Mischel, who is also the designer of the experiment, The Marshmallow Test, in the 70s, I think. Basically, just talking about how you can master your own self-control, how you can delay instant gratification for a much bigger reward in the future. Now, I'm sure you've seen all the viral videos right now on Instagram or TikTok or wherever on social media where the kids are asked to wait. That's basically the marshmallow test. And they found that that's actually a big indication of success in life. So the more you try and master that, it actually is gonna have a big, big impact on your life. And like the book says, your view of human nature will change profoundly as you read this brilliant book. Next up, and I've said that in my last video too, meditation is something that's super important. I've been meditating a lot. I think it really, really makes a difference because our days kind of blend in a little bit. So it just helps you stay focused. I got a little distracted because someone's walking by. I've got another update regarding this apartment later on in this video, so stick around. But the book I've got here is Mindfulness by Gil Hassan, and I thought it was a great elementary guide to how to meditate, how to be more mindful, how to be more present. Like if you haven't touched that topic generally and you feel like, I don't know, you need to be like a hipster yoga, yogi type dude, disregard all of that. This is a very like modern worldly approach to it, and I really, really liked it, so I thought I'd recommend that to you. Another book that I love reading was called The Slow Fix, because if you guys, I mean, the ones that are watching this video, I'm assuming are probably like the ODS squad that watch pretty much every video, because otherwise why would you check out a quarantine update video from this random stranger? But if you know me, assuming you do know me, I'm a little bit impatient, and I like fixing things quickly. I like getting them out of my brain. So when I read this book, it definitely impacted me. It's called The Slow Fix by Carl Honoré, and it talks about how to solve problems, work smarter and better, and knowing that you can't just fix something that easily, like giving things the time to breathe and develop and improve over time. I think that was a big, big lesson for me. So I think this is a great book. And again, the situation we're in right now is definitely not gonna be a quick fix either. So maybe there's a wisdom in there that's pertaining to the situation we're in right now. And then last but not least, if you guys are doing great and you are like, motivated and want to start some new, 0 to 1 by Peter Thiel is a great book. Kind of like taking your hand and walking you through how to build something new, you know, how to structure it. It says notes on startups or how to build the future. Whether it is really like a startup company that you want to do it, it's a great book. But like I said, the book says, just how you structure your future. And I think we have such a big reset button right now that I think this is a great read. So now that we've covered books, it is something like that I do a lot right now. I'm reading a lot. I've all read in the past, but I think they're great quarantine reads. Something else I've been doing that's obviously like as an extrovert that I am is trying to connect with people however I can, whether that's calling them, FaceTiming them all over the world, which I think is just great to like show some love to the people that you love. Zoom games, I don't know if you, you know, I'm sure you've played some by now, but there's a great party pack that's called Jackbox. So if you want to download Jackbox, they have party packs in there with different games that are really, really fun to play over Zoom. But also the people that are around you, try and go for social distancing walks or hikes, wear your mask, keep the distance. Go outside, even if you do it by yourself, like walking and hiking, just getting outdoors in a controlled, safe manner and responsible manner has been honestly like a game changer. Just a little bit of a walk can clear your mind up like crazy. And yes, if this was an actual walk, I'd wear my face mask and give you some of that motivation and inspiration back. There's actually some science behind seeing green, like nature trees, that actually makes you happy. I've been trying to keep active. It's been a little bit of a struggle because I felt a little bit limited with what I can do at home. But I have a video coming up where I talk about affordable options for you guys to shop on Amazon that where you can honestly limitlessly expand your abilities to work out at home. And it's not heavy dumbbells, it's not super expensive. So make sure to stay tuned for that. It's coming in the video real soon. There's also a bunch of online classes like on Instagram Live. If you like Barry's, if you like Rumble, Tone House in New York. Tone House, you have to pay for it, but a lot of the classes are for free online, well, on Instagram, and I think those are great just so you feel a little bit of a communal drive and spirit and motivation to like actually get you to work out. In terms of nutrition, I've been trying to limit sugar snacking and try and opt for some more healthy snacks, but limit alcohol. And a buddy of mine recommended Spindrifts to me, which are flavored like kind of like LaCroix, however you want to pronounce it in American English. But they're honestly a lot better, and they're like a really nice, they're like a treat, but really, really healthy because basically it's just sparkling water. So it's much better than soda. And I enjoy drinking ciders. So basically it's like a cider substitute too, rather than drinking like a couple ciders. I maybe don't have a cider, or maybe I just have one cider and have a couple cans of Spindrift. So I wanted to mention that. If you guys like it, I'll drop the link down below. It's not sponsored or anything. I just really, really like them. And yeah, so I mentioned the apartment. This is the LA loft, and I'm going to shoot a LA apartment tour for you guys really soon, but we're gonna be leaving this apartment very, very soon as well. As you can see, we live on the ground floor with massive windows, which is great, but there's several things that are like not perfect about this apartment. We're also moving out of our New York apartment, so both apartments are gonna be gone, and we're gonna have one main apartment here in LA, which we still are on the hunt for. But with that news, there's related news. I'm flying to New York this week, which feels a little bit weird because that's obviously where the epicenter was in the US, and like everything is a bit more mellow, but we have to move because our lease is up. So I'm gonna be on a plane, I'm gonna be in New York because we have a bunch of plants and I don't necessarily want to fly back also. We are going to drive back through the US to LA in a Suburban. So that's gonna be interesting. And hopefully I'm planning on shooting something around that, whether it's a vlog or just like a little one day trip, but I'm excited to show you. I've been wanting to drive across the country literally forever, so I'm really excited to do that. That's kind of like the update on my end. Oh, something else. As I was falling asleep yesterday, I was thinking a lot about 30 day challenges and like in terms of self-improvement. I know they're a big thing on YouTube already, but I would really like to like try several of them back to back, possibly overlapping. I would love to know what you guys think would be interesting to see in terms of a 30 day challenge completed by yours truly. Yeah, that's it. I hope you guys are staying safe, sane wherever you are. I'm hoping that the whole quarantine thing is easing up for you guys and you have a little bit more freedom again and that you're doing great otherwise, but that's it for me. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this little update. Leave comments, thoughts, questions down below, and I'll see you very soon with the next one. Until then, stay dapper. Bye, y'all.